In addition to Republicans taking over the House of Representatives this week, we also had all of the governors, state legislatures, and all of those other folks who won in 2022 get sworn in. And one of those people, of course, was Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, who cruised to the easiest reelection victory in the state of Florida, winning by 1.5 million votes, the largest margin ever in this state. So he got to give his little inaugural speech on Tuesday when he was sworn in for his second term. And it was about as boring and stupid as you would expect. See, DeSantis didn't talk about his goals for a second term. He didn't talk about his accomplishments in his first term. What did he do? Well, he told us very clearly, Florida will never surrender to the woke mob. Florida is where woke goes to die, he said in that cadence. Once again, Ron DeSantis had the opportunity to go out there and say, all right, thank you for putting me back in power. Here is what I'm going to do for the state. Nope, didn't do it. He attacked something that doesn't exist. He attacked this boogeyman of woke that Republicans have created that they legally can't even define because DeSantis's lawyers were forced to define it in court and failed miserably at that. So they don't know what it is, but more importantly, their constituents don't know what it is. So they can go out there and fight woke all day, and the Republican voters, of course, are going to love it. They're going to be like, oh my God, this guy's fighting for me. He took on the woke. But if you ever stop and ask one of these people, all right, cool, what is woke? They can't tell you. But more importantly about DeSantis's speech, once again ranting and raving about this mythical boogeyman, is that this was also kind of seen as him prepping a presidential run. I think it's pretty obvious at this point that DeSantis is eventually going to run for president. This inaugural speech was supposed to kind of be the kickoff a little bit. But he didn't list a single policy. He didn't talk about the fact that the state under his leadership has seen the largest increase in housing prices in the country since he took over. Florida is now one of the most unaffordable places to live in the United States. He's letting the big real estate investors come in, buy up entire communities, jack up the prices to where nobody can afford them. We've got pollution running rampant throughout the state. Algae blooms, red tide, all kinds of horrible things happening. Unemployment. You name it, Florida's got it, and it's bad. And Ron DeSantis has no answers, which of course is why he attacks woke. And that may win in Florida. We've all seen the headlines about Florida, man. We know we got a lot of stupid people down here, let's be honest. But that's not going to work on a national stage, Ron. When you get up there on a debate stage, whether it's against your fellow Republicans or against a Democratic nominee, and the only word you know how to say is woke, you're going to go down in flames. They're going to eat you alive because you have no idea how to govern. And you're not interested in governing. You're just interested in obtaining power, which is exactly what you've done. But now you don't know what to do with it. So you've spent 4 years and you're about to spend another 4 years attacking already marginalized communities in the state because you know that your supporters love to see that because they're not the ones being oppressed. But you try to bring that crap onto the national stage and this country is going to absolutely destroy you and send your ass packing back to Tallahassee.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.